Hello and welcome. Today we're going to be going over An American in Paris. This is like the second scene where we see Jerry Mulligan have the first interaction with a woman, and it's this educated woman from college, and she's expressing an opinion, and he kind of blows her off. He frames it like as disdain for just the kind of snooty college kid culture that they have there, but I think it sets up a kind of pattern that you see later on in the film. And this is also where we meet Milo, his benefactor, this upper-class older woman. We see in this scene that she has a more forward attitude than what we'll see later on with Lise, and that she kind of knows what she wants and she'll go after it. And that kind of makes Jerry uncomfortable, it seems. I wanted to also point out, in the mise-en-scene here, they're both eye-to-eye. They're equal height, almost always. And that's different from the heroine later. She's much shorter than Jerry. In the scene with the cafe, he kind of just takes Lise away from her friends, in a, like a rather forceful kind of way. This would be a major red flag nowadays, and so you can kind of see what kind of behavior was expected or acceptable for men around that time, and it's kind of being reinforced in this movie here, and you'll see it again and again. I mean, he's basically holding her hostage here, and then starts singing her a love song. Yeah, in the context of today, this would be really terrifying. And then on the ride back, Milo is justifiably angry at him. Jerry practically ignored Milo the entire night, despite not only her being the one who invited him out in the first place, but also being a patron, a potential patron, someone who would fund his career. Jerry doesn't seem to care about that, and I think that's reinforced time and again, that he doesn't like these forward women, these more dominant women, and as the hero, that influences, you know, the viewers, the audience. And then we see the next morning Milo is, you know, back at it, you know, still conducting business, still kind of flirting with him, kind of just moving forward with it. And Jerry is definitely unsettled by this, or not unsettled, but just thrown for a loop, because that's not the kind of woman he deals with usually. It's not the kind of woman he prefers. At least, that's my opinion. She definitely has a more domineering personality, and she's leaning in like that, and then she's touching him, and, you know, definitely more aggressive in this romantic relationship she's trying to pursue. And that's not at all enticing to Jerry, and as a hero, I mean, you kind of have to side with him, and you might come away thinking that maybe this woman is a little too much, and that's not attractive. And then the fact that she apologizes and that Jerry does not apologize says to the audience that Jerry should be allowed to pursue his art, quote unquote. without consequences, and that the woman's reaction was inappropriate or overreaching, which is just wrong. And then he goes to Elise's work on the same day that he called her and she rejected him a second time, and now he's come to be rejected a third time. In the same moment, we're also introduced to this other upper-class lady who is portrayed as kind of silly and indecisive. That she's panicked easily by making decisions, and then Jerry has to come in and take the decision away from her and save her from that by choosing for her with his man's perspective or what have you. And that's something that's repeated again later on in the film when Lise is being taken away and she says, "Don't let me be taken away from you like this," to Jerry, basically giving up her agency in the matter. When this movie came out in 1951, it won like several awards. Most of those Academy Awards, and Gene Kelly was one of the most iconic actors from the golden age of Hollywood, so it definitely left an impact on our culture. You can definitely understand and see how these concepts regarding gender roles are embedded into our society, especially at such a formative time. I mean, right after World War I, and the economy was, I think, still booming, and cinema was becoming a huge thing, and then circulating information. It just, of course, made an impact.